Minutes show the Chief Executive Short Committee that our course on the delivery side there would be an accountability framework, and that the performance management of these directors would have to assure themselves that services were being delivered to a satisfactory standard. Finally advised that the accountability framework had already been worked out for adult care, but that it was still being worked out around children's services. Councillor Green is obviously the same, he did not believe the matrix management worked. Committee resolved at point 9 that before the council implements the proposed structure on 1st November, there is a review of the framework and details relating to children's services subject to findings of Ofsted. In his report to the Employment Committee of the 11th of October, the Chief Executive reported his proposed interim children's senior management structure, stating that for the immediate future, children's services will report directly to the Chief Executive whilst the improvement work required by Ofsted structure will be reviewed and aligned with the new operating model when Children's Services Improvement Plan has been delivered successfully. My questions are that given that it's still the Chief Executive's intention to bring Children's Services within the scope of the new operating model as soon as Children's Care Services are improved, and given that the concerns of members across the piece about the disconnect between strategy and delivery and matrix management have not yet been reported back to the committee. Firstly, is the leader satisfied that a proper review has taken place of the management framework that will succeed the interim management arrangements? Secondly, if the new operating model is fit for purpose in running children's services, why is it considered inadequate for dealing with the current situation? And finally, will he agree that the whole structure collapses if it can't satisfactorily demonstrate to be adequate in the management of children's services now, and will the leader of the council postpone the introduction of the new operating model until members are really satisfied that it will be fit for purpose?
Can I thank Councillor Kelly for advance notice of his question? The response is as follows to the first question. The report to the Employment Appointments Committee on the 11th of October proposed that the interim structure be reviewed by the Children's Services Improvement Plan has been delivered successfully. The management framework has been proposed following consideration of structures and approaches used in other councils who are or who have been in a similar position in the Wirral. The Chief Executive assumes direct leadership of the service area to ensure that the necessary improvements will be delivered. Question two, the position with Children's Services is quite specific. Making the necessary improvements is an absolute priority for the as already stated, it's important that the improvement agenda is led by the Chief Exec. It is imperative that the Council as a whole and all our partners play their part in delivering improvements. The approach adopted and operating model is consistent with other councils that have successfully improved children's services. And the third question, the response is as well as the new operating model provides a structure and a platform to deliver not only the improvements required to children's services, but all the council's priorities as set out in the Wirral 2020 plan. That includes delivering our pledges, achieving agreed outcomes for communities and residents, focused service delivery, and securing the most suitable delivery models going forward. I do not, therefore, believe it is appropriate to postpone the implementation of the new operating model. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Councillor Davis. Recommendations from reducing pedestrian casualties in the borough. And I'll advise again Michael, Councillor Michael Sullivan, Chair of the Business Owned Street Committee, to move the recommendation as contained again in the front page of the agenda, which is on page 55 and 56.
So moved, Mr. Mayor.
Seconded, yeah. All those in favour? She votes against. I'm abstaining. That's carried. Thank you very much. Okay, item 9 on your agenda, vacancies. So, item 9 on the agenda, the Head of Legal and Member Services have been notified of changes to outside bodies and council committees and as indicated on the contents page of the agenda. They are as follows. Committee memberships, people overview of scrutiny, Councillor Chris Blakely to replace Councillor John Hale as the deputy. Environment overview of scrutiny, again Councillor Blakely to replace Councillor Charlie Pogle as a deputy. Outside bodies to reconfirm. Firstly, item A on page 57 of the agenda.